gotta live like Jesus. Philippians 2:7 says, but Christ Jesus made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. Gotta think about that for a minute.
Hello, it is written that I am saved. If I keep his commands, I confess his name. Jesus, he forgave me of my sins, so I feel no shame. Hello, every knee is gonna bow at the sound of his name. Jesus, willingly he died on the cross and shed his blood for me. On Calvary, Jesus died and he knew no sin. Descended and conquered death when he rose again.
The truth never really dawned on a lot of people because they mistakenly think that Jesus was able to work wonders, perform miracles, and to live above sin because he had divine powers that we don't possess. Therefore, they never really aspired to live like he lived, you know? Most people say, I could never live like Jesus did. After all, he had an advantage. He was God. They don't realize that when Jesus came to earth, he voluntarily gave up that advantage, living his life here not as God, but as a man. He had no supernatural powers. He had no ability to perform miracles until after he was anointed by the Holy Spirit, as recorded in Luke 3:22. He worked wonders, not by his own power, but by the power of the Father, saying, the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. John 14:10. And when he prayed not as a divine one, who had authority as God, but as a man. He walked obediently with God. And as Hebrews 5:7 says, his prayers were heard not because of his deity, but because of his reverence toward God. Jesus, the divine Son of God, set aside the privileges and powers of deity for a time and lived as a man on earth. Once you grasp that, it will absolutely thrill your soul. Why? Because it means that you, as a reborn child of God, filled with the same spirit as Jesus was, have the same opportunity to live as he lived on earth. In fact, that is exactly what he intends. In John 17:18, he said to the Father, just as you sent me into the world, I also sent them into the world. Jesus sent you and me into the world to live as he lived. Through the new birth, he enabled you to exchange the sinful nature of Adam for the sinless nature of God. He gave us the opportunity and the command to live above sin, to live in fellowship with the Father, to preach the gospel and to heal the sick, to raise the dead and to cast out demons and make disciples. Once we realize that, we'll throw off the shackles of doubt that have held us back and begin to live as Jesus meant us to live. Not as a sin-ridden son of fallen man, but as a reborn child of the Most High God. Then those around us will actually begin to see Jesus in us. 1 John 3:1-8.
Cause of the things I be saying, my God, for they soul I be praying, and they salvation every day I be praying. Now it's not the time for delay, the rapture's coming, proceed tribulation. I was sent to get your clarification. The mark of the beast is eternal damnation. Chapter 14 in the book of Revelation. Jesus.